DUMB is an acronym for Deep Underground Military Bases. According to eyewitnesses, they're about the size of a medium-sized city, anywhere from 10 miles to 30 miles across, with an average depth of 4.25 miles. In America alone, there's at least 140 of them. Most of the tunneling activity is under military installations. These underground cities have reportedly been under construction day and night since the 1940s. Worldwide, there's about 1,500 of them. The Northrop facility in Antelope Valley, California, is rumored to be 42 levels deep. Ex-employees and whistleblowers describe what sounds like the underground setting for a science fiction movie. Tunnel machines that dig a mile of tunnel big enough for a two-lane highway in a matter of minutes. High-speed magnetic levitation trains traveling between underground cities at fantastic speeds of up to 1,500 miles per hour. Richard Souter, who wrote a book called Underground Bases and Tunnels, What is the Government Trying to Hide? Souter has an architectural PhD, and he's worked for a number of government agencies. His book describes a nuclear power laser drill called the Subterrane, capable of drilling an underground tunnel 7 miles long in a single day. It literally melts the rock away that's in its path and leaves behind a smooth, glazed, glass-like surface around the edges of the tunnels. Another credible witness is a retired U.S. Air Force Colonel, L. Fletcher Prouty. He wrote a book in 1973 called The Secret Team, explaining how underground cities are hidden from public view. From 1955 to 1963, Prouty was the liaison between the CIA and the Department of Defense for military support of special operations. The Secret Team, which he names after his book, is a powerful, brutally violent international team that overthrows and influences governments all over the globe. At the core of the Secret Team are members of the CIA, the National Security Council, military and civilian officials, as well as academics, business, and even media people. Each underground city is said to employ 10,000 to 18,000 workers and cost between $17 and $26 billion to build. Where does all that money come from? It comes from a concealed black budget that garners 25% of the gross U.S. national product, and it currently consumes $1.25 trillion per year. Ever wonder what happened to the trillions in so-called losses after the bankster crooks fleeced the world's major financial institutions, then got rewarded with taxpayer bailouts? Ever wonder what happens to the billions that they pocket from Afghanistan's opium trade and from the legal and illegal drug money? In Tim Weiner's book, The Blank Check, The Pentagon's Black Budget, he writes, there are two governments in the United States today. One is visible, the other is invisible. The first is the government that citizens read about in their local newspapers, and the second is highly secretive, interlocking agencies that carry out hidden agendas. Philip Schneider, an ex-government structural engineer, was involved in building deep underground military bases around the United States. For the last 2 years of his life, he gave public lectures about government cover-ups, black budgets, UFOs, and aliens. On January 17, 1996, Schneider was found dead in his apartment with piano wire wrapped around his neck. Some say he was tortured and murdered in a military-style execution. James Casbolt is another whistleblower. Casbolt was a former MI6 agent who worked in black ops in London between 1995 and 1999. He has connections to ex-intelligence people who worked in underground bases and on ET-related projects. There are vast numbers of children and adults disappearing around the world and ending up in these underground bases, says Casbolt. Why in hell are governments building a global underground network of cities with interconnecting tunnels?
Alexa, who is in control of the underground tunnels under the Getty Museum in California?
The Getty Museum does not have control over the underground tunnels beneath its premises in California. The tunnels, which run underneath the museum, are reportedly a part of a larger network that extends for several miles and includes bunkers and other facilities. However, the ownership and management of the tunnels are attributed to the Central Intelligence Agency, CIA, and the National Security Agency, NSA, two U.S. intelligence agencies.
Right now, there are 131 active deep underground military bases in the United States. There's 1,477 of them worldwide. Each one has an average cost $17 to $19 billion. Each one is built in the site of, it'd take a year to 2 years to build each one, and now they're capable of building a couple of them a year with sophisticated methods. My colleague Al Bielek has actually been on some of the high-speed railways, the magneto-leviton trains that connect all the deep underground military bases within the United States. He's been on a Mach 2 train and floats off a single rail and a 3/4 inch off a rail, and is what you call high tech. We have nothing like this on the surface. Grim Lake is where the infamous Area 51, S4, S2, a CIA base, it was originally a bombing range, a nuclear test site. It was later become the most secret base in the United States. It employs over 18,000 workers, work in shifts of 12 hours at a whack. Most of them work in the cover of darkness, like us. We built out 9 underground military bases there, each with an average capacity, capable of what's basically a city underground, roughly 4.25 cubic miles hollowed out underground. They have boring machines, for instance. They don't bore. They literally vitrify and melt the rock, deflagrate the rock. It's a very sophisticated laser melting and deflagrating system. It reduces the rock to a powder and then melts the remaining rock as a coating on the inside of the base, so you don't have to use gunite, cements, and other kinds of things like that. That's all old hat now. Technology is just basically the new technology we get is the old hat of the military. Anyway, after we drilled all 4 holes, it's about 2 days to drill all 4 of them. And when you build an underground base, you drill 4 basic holes, and then you build, you call stopes or cross member holes across, and you use blasting equipment and special blasting equipment by the analyzation of the rock formation. And you literally blast out or tunnel out or deflagrate or melt rock out to build the large rooms that are required for this underground base. I was involved in building another base inside of Dulce, New Mexico, which is Los Alamos Laboratory. It's a biological laboratory on the southwest part of the Archuleta Mesa. We built an underground facility, a better part of 3 cubic miles, hollowed out underground. Then to the southwest of that, we were in the process of the early stages of building. We drilled 4 large tunnel-like holes. Some of them ran 2.5 miles under the surface. Number of the original drilling machines that were used were at the rate of 2 miles a day. Area 51 is only one base, one of the 131 bases. Of these 131 bases, I call Area 51 a mega base. It's got more than one base. Stonopah Test Range, Area 51, S2, S4, Groom Lake, and a host of others. Now, these mega bases are gobbling up our gross national product. Right now we're spending 28% of the gross national product on building underground bases sold. That doesn't count for the defense budget. That doesn't count for the spare parts budget. wouldn't count for any of that at all. And the black budget is dead, dead wrong. It sidesteps the United States Congress and its constitution of its people and says you're a bunch of morons, you don't need to know. On a need-to-know basis is an executive order written during the Eisenhower era, right after the created 1954 treaty, and is treasonous and illegal in this country and should be overturned and abolished. All this alien thing is fine, except for one thing. Alien takeover is a serious threat. Kept totally out of the public view, off the surface, I'm sure the underground bases, without question, are being used as a place to house alien takeover. Alien takeover means the implementation of a one-world government.
Now pay close attention to how he says this part here.
All this alien thing is fine, except for one thing. Alien takeover is a serious threat. Kept totally out of the public view, off the surface, I'm sure the underground bases, without question, are being used as a place to house alien takeover. Alien takeover means the implementation of a one-world government.
Are also involved in the child sex slave industry. They themselves have been caught in compromising positions, and they too, as perverted people, have risen to their higher ranks in the military because of those things. Somewhat like Michael Aquino, perhaps, if some of you remember him. And of course, we can easily imagine who's building the tunnels. And we are in a spiritual war, folks. And I would say it's the converted versus the perverted now. It's that simple. Those who worship Yahweh and those who worship Satan. Those who believe in loving one another and those who believe in molesting and torturing one another. But this also fits other parts of scripture and prophecy too, like how many who are not saved are going to hide under the rocks and dens, calling out, "Fall on us and hide us from the wrath of him that has come." And I believe that's why they're building the tunnels, because they know that someday Yahweh is going to come and defend us. But only those of us who are found worthy of that defense. And I pray that every one of you that I know is going to be found worthy of that defense. May Yahweh return to those of us who love him very soon.
The love of God is so perfect. Oh, how I love thy law.
Yes, I do. Tonight's question is... Hello.
Hi.
With the recent release of Pentagon... footage of unidentified aerial phenomena and things like Project Blue Book and ATIP and all of these various things. In your former position and currently with the current information that's released, what's your viewpoint on what these objects that seem to defy all laws of physics are?
Well, first of all, that's a legitimate question now. The short answer, but not the most meaningful one, is I don't know about this. But when I was president and I had a chief of staff, John Podesta, who loved science fiction, we made every attempt to find out everything about Roswell. and we also sent people to Area 51 to make sure there were no aliens in a deep... because Area 51 is very important.
Who do you send to Area 51?
Oh, if I told you that.
Hey guys, thanks for watching, and I just wanted to give a quick message. This video is really tough to make, and it's because the government is going over time on censoring this topic, this and the nuclear topic. I thought that the depopulation censorship was bad, but I mean, this is a lot worse. And unfortunately, when the government goes over time on censoring something, it's because the topic at hand is very serious, and it poses a threat to the continuity of the government. That's how serious it was. That's how serious it is. If this information were to go mainstream, I mean, all hell would break loose. And I'm not just talking about things I found in this video, but I'm talking about the things that I will upload on my channel in the future, as well as the things that I'm not even allowed to upload. If you compiled all of that information and you advertised that to the masses, it would be a disaster for the government because it would completely ruin the deck of cards that they have set up. I mean, the balancing act they have going on is really delicate. And for stuff like this to come out to the public, to come out to the light of day, is really serious stuff. So I'm not surprised at all that this stuff is being censored, and it was really hard to make this video. I really wanted to have better content on this. However, you know, there's just so many people talking about aliens and QAnon and stuff like that. It's like, I mean, there's a lot of crazies, you know, talking about this too. And unfortunately, that's on purpose, you know, it's to discredit the whole investigation of the matter. And it's been quite effective, you know, it's hardly been talked about, but it's all by design. But anyways, thank you guys for watching. I'm gonna keep looking for more evidence and maybe enough to warrant a second video on this in the near future. I'll definitely revisit it anyways. You know, I'm just gonna make my own content instead of like a compilation type of video. But for now, this is kind of my lazy way of getting the information out to you guys. And you know, I curate the best stuff for you guys. I don't settle for mediocre stuff. I try to look for the best footage for you guys. But anyways, until the next video, again, thank you for watching, and subscribe and like if you enjoyed the video. You know, share the video in case this gets taken down. There's so much footage that has been scrubbed. I mean, it's unbelievable. But yeah, I'll see you in the next video, guys. Thanks.